so the decision was nearly taken out of her hands.
Hey, Steve.
Bye, Laura.
Where are you going?
Moscow, methinks.
Russia? Why?
I'm going to visit my parents.
How long will you be gone?
Forever. Maybe longer.
What's going on? Why are you leaving?
Oh, Laura, I feel so foolish. The other night, when I proposed to you, it was very kind of you not to laugh in my face.
Steve, why would I do that?
Oh, come on. There's no comparison between Stefan and me. It's like getting a proposal from Brad Pitt, and then 5 minutes later getting another one from Mr. Bean.
Steve, don't be so hard on yourself. I took your proposal very seriously.
You did?
I sure did.
Thank you, Laura. I'll savor that morsel when I'm sipping borscht at Starbucks in Red Square.
Steve, listen.
No, you listen, sweetheart. Stefan is the man for you. With him, you'll live an exciting, glamorous life. And you'll be with a handsome man who never falls down.
Steve!
Well, what can I possibly offer you compared to that? A modest existence in a tiny apartment crammed with test tubes and cheese?
Steve, but how can you just leave? You told me you love me.
I do love you. I adore you. I worship the rain waters the grass that grows on the ground you walk on. All I've ever wanted to do is make you happy. Well, the only way I believe I can do that is if I step aside. Goodbye, Laura. I do have one favor. I ask of you one small favor. Remember me.
Steve, wait! You can't just leave.
Why not?
Because I can't imagine my life without you.
What are you trying to say?
Well, I'm saying that I love you and I want to marry you.
Toast to your new son-in-law, Steve Urkel.